So it's so awkward. I still feel like I'm bigger, right? Probably because I am just bigger.
Yeah, Alex, I've got the shortest body in the world.
You do actually.
Thank you. Like a child.
You're so tall normally compared to me. You've got like, that's why you can run really fast.
Probably.
You've got long legs.
Probably. That's why I look like a child.
Okay, hey guys, I'm here with Tashi, who is PT, runner, blogger, Instagrammer, friend. We got to know each other very well when we spent, what was it, like 24 hours on the bus in Tennessee.
Yeah.
Last year when we were doing the Ragnar Relay with Reebok. And Tashi qualified as a PT last year.
Yeah, in December time.
Yeah, and she is going to help put me through my paces to get me really, really strong for Boston, for the Boston qualifier even, because I'm not into Boston yet.
But you will be.
I will be, fingers crossed. So that's what we're working towards. And so many of you guys wanted tips and strength workouts that are specific for runners. Mm-hmm. And that is where you come in.
Yeah, so I guess let me talk a bit about me and my like background in running and training. So I've always ran as a child. I used to do track work, and then like most people, you kind of fall off in your late teens.
Yeah.
When you go to university, partying and drinking. And then in my early 20s, I got back into running. I started doing like 5Ks, but I've always done sort of like the gym work, always my strength training, and because of that, I think that's probably why.
Your Barry's.
Yeah.
If you look at Tashi's Instagram, she's literally a Barry's like 3-4 days a week.
I have to put a cap on it now, it's like ridiculous.
Like smoothie after smoothie.
Yeah. But I think for me, strength training's been key for my running journey, because no matter sort of what distance I sort of throw myself at, I remain injury free, and I can kind of guess where we're doing the bare minimum.
What's your half marathon time like?
1:38.
So
yeah, that was Royal Parks last
year. She's
really
fast.
Yeah. But so yeah, I want to try and get more people just doing strength training. Like, you don't have to do super heavy weights. It's just a little bit here and there, two to three sessions a week. You don't have to sort of sacrifice your running to get your strength training, which I know is really hard when you're doing sort of 50-mile weeks, which is probably what you do. I never do 50-mile
weeks. I only do like later on in marathon training, don't worry.
It can be really hard, it's really tiring. Yeah. When I trained for London, I was just exhausted all the time. And the thought of having to go into the gym, as well as run my miles, was disgusting. So yeah, I want to help you guys and Charlie, and I want you guys to follow our journey to getting Charlie towards that BQ, but also showing you that you don't have to be in the gym for 3 hours a day. You don't have to be squatting.
I think that's the great thing. Tasha sent me some workouts for my Tokyo stuff, and they were like 30-minute sessions, and that feels really achievable for me, and it's not intimidating. They were mostly weights that I didn't have to Google to look up how to do them. And I think it's, making it fit around your running training rather than it being like 3 hours a week that you have to dedicate to that you're just going to be like, oh, I can't be bothered.
Yes, exactly.
So why is running strength training so important for runners?
So I guess the basis of strength training for runners is it's all about training the muscles that you use for running so that when you run, you hit the ground, you've got a lot more force, which means that you're going to move a lot faster, you're going to fatigue and tire less, which is why it's so important to have a strong core, because you always see people running and their arms are flailing.
I end up running like this again, and I'm like, oh, and I get lower back like pain towards the end of a marathon.
Yeah, that's probably maybe you're leaning too forward or you're hunched over. So it's all about looking at the muscles that are used during running, conditioning them, strengthening them, allowing your body to adapt to when you're actually running. There's a lot of runners just sort of train like front and back, but really you need to be like squatting to the sides, squatting backwards, because when when you run, you can land awkwardly on something and that's it, your race is over.
Yeah.
So it's all about conditioning your muscles, that if you land kind of off balance, you're fine because you've done it in your training.
That's a really good point, yeah.
Yeah, I learned that recently. And also probably the most important thing about strengthening your muscles running is to prevent injury. The stronger you are, the less likely you are to injure. So whether it's your calves, your hamstrings, even your upper body muscles, it's just having a really strong body. Think of your body as your engine, and when you get to the start line, you know that you're in the best shape and you're ready to go.
That's so interesting about the calves. I've always thought I've got really tight calves.
Yeah.
stretch them more.
Yeah.
And recently I got told that actually I need to strengthen them more.
Yeah.
And I was like, surely that is counterintuitive, but apparently that helps the force of, you know, the fact that I heel strike and go.
Yes, exactly. Well, there's a lot of myth about tight muscles, and one of the theories is that the reason why your body feels tight is because it simply isn't strong enough to do whatever it is you want it to do.
Okay.
So, for example, if you're going on a run, a really, really long run, and your calves start to hurt, it's like, no, your calves aren't tight, it's just they aren't strong enough to do whatever it is that you want them to do. So, of course, you do need to stretch and you do need to foam roll, but having sort of tight calves and like tight ankles for a runner isn't the end of the world, because you do need to have a little bit of restriction.
Yeah.
If you're too flexible, you're going to be rolling your ankle all the time, and you're going to be injuring yourself. So yeah, it's not having tight muscles isn't always a bad thing.
Okay,
but
that's good to know.
Yeah,
I'm sure that's you.
Yeah, I'm sure that's you, tight. Yeah.
How she says it's fine.
It's not what I said. It's just not the end of the world.
Okay. Yeah. So there's stuff we can work on to help build the strength, and then also probably address some of the tight.
Yes, exactly.
And something that I know is a bit controversial is the whole weight loss around strength training, because I personally eat loads when I'm marathon training, and I sometimes lose weight, but most often actually I stay at stable weight regardless of the fact that I'm exercising for like 10 hours a week. The thing that makes a difference to my body is HIIT and strength.
Yes.
And there must be, like, there's a happy medium, isn't there?
Yes,
exactly. Racing weight.
Yeah, everyone, we all have in our mind our goal weight and our goal time when we're racing.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, I guess with marathon running, if you're perhaps not fueling enough of the right food, and because you're running for such a long time, your body is just eating away into your muscle.
Yeah.
And the less muscle you have, like, the less your body's ability to burn calories is. So that perhaps is why a lot of people... But that's probably why, you know, a lot of runners, when they do a marathon, they're like, oh my god, like, why am I putting on weight?
Hungry
all the time is, you can't prevent that. I guess it's just making smarter choices, which is what you know so much more about than I do. Just sort of having bigger carb portions and eating around your training.
Yeah, making sure you're getting the right amount of protein.
Exactly.
You can do a whole other sort of session on.
Yeah, you can teach me.
Exactly.
Yeah,
practice, I guess. That's what I preach.
Yeah. But yeah, one of the benefits with weight training is that it does sculpt your body and tone your body. I find that I have a lot more muscle definition when I'm weight training as opposed to just doing like cardio.
Exactly. It needs to be sort of a
happy balance. So that doesn't necessarily mean that because you're running 5 times a week, you have to be strength training 5 times a week.
Good.
I don't think anyone's body is capable of doing that, unless you're like a professional athlete.
Or I guess if you were doing like 20 minutes running and...
Yeah, and you get to nap during the day and you don't work and you can just run sports massages. But yeah, what we're trying to do is show you guys that it can be done, and it doesn't have to be too far removed from your daily routine and interrupt your running routine.
Yeah, so I think what I'm going to be doing is sort of 4 to 5 days a week maximum running, and then so 4 days a week running, and then 2 to 3 days a week strength stuff. And you know, some of the stuff we were doing strength wise was a bit more, not HIIT, but it was like got the heart rate up, so it's sort of counts both cardio and strength. Try and get really strong, really fit, and get this BQ. So we're going to be doing a mixture of things like hotel workouts, because I know it's summer and lots of you are traveling.
Even if after you finish your run, if it's like a short tempo run, go to the park, do your press ups, do whatever.
Everyone always says that they do this. I am so nervous. I will never ever do
that. I do it all the time. No one watches.
So we're going to do some like body weight exercise ones. So one is that if you have a few weights that you could do at home in like a home gym or your sitting room or something, and then some proper gym workouts. There is like a balance, isn't there, between getting heavy enough.
Yes,
that
exactly.
I've read quite a lot recently.
Yeah.
Not understood at all, but that you need to actually lift quite heavy sometimes.
Yeah, you do, but that's not all the time. So, for example, with you, we're going to be doing like, we've got 16 weeks.
14.
14 weeks. We're going to do 14 weeks.
I was carrying like big bundles of hair. I've got like scratches all over from building the school.
Yeah. So we're going to do like a training cycle, whereas there will be 4 weeks of heavy lifting.
Okay.
And then the other 10 weeks well, someone will be heavier than others, but it's not, you know, you don't have to go in heavy every single
week. So it's kind of a bit like the running where you have weeks that are heavy loads and then weeks that are like step back. So that'll be the same for the
And then with your heavy running, like the lifting load will be like minuscule compared to what you were doing. So,
we're doing like a 20-22 miler will be a
you just do maintenance work in the gym. You weren't really looking to be
that's
strong.
Good to know.
Maintenance. Yes.
Do you guys have anything else?
No, I think that's it. I'm excited. We hope that you enjoy the workout.
Yeah. And comment below and let us know if there's any specific areas you want us to focus on or any like type of workouts that you want, like more home workouts, more bodyweight workouts, that sort of thing. It's going to be over the 14-week period. Some of them are going to be with Tashi. Some of them are going to be workouts that she sent me to prove that you don't actually have to have a personal trainer with you all the time. You can use one of these workouts on your own or find something from like Pinterest or screenshot one of the workouts that we share on Instagram. And no excuse not to get your strength workout in, basically.
Yeah, sometimes we do have excuses, like, I know we're tired of it. But yeah, always just try. I always like to let you train the first thing in the day.
Yeah.
Because then it's done.
Tashi is not morning person.
Okay, when I say first thing, I mean like,
I'm not first thing. Tashi's like, she'll meet at 9.
Right. I'll wake up at 7 and then...
Yeah. You were like, I don't want any middle of the night. You were like, the earliest I'm willing to do is 7.
Like, why wake up at like 7?
I had to do a 3 a.m. one. I'm going to link the videos that we took in Tennessee to roasted vlogs, didn't we? And they're quite fun to watch. So then you can get to know us both a bit more as well. So great, I'm excited.
Me too.